Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you this fine day? Me, I am having a great time exploring in more depth the world of webinars. If you've been following our channel, you know that I've been looking more and more seriously at the world of webinars. So something a little bit different today. I'm going to ask you a big favor as well as deliver some awesome content. We're going to cover what I consider to be the 7 steps to creating great webinars. But I have a special ask of you, which I will do in just a few seconds. All right, here is the deal. I am about to dive into what I consider to be the 7 keys to creating great webinars. And frankly, there's probably 700 keys to creating great webinars, depending on what's important to your particular audience. But I'm going to look at 7 general keys. But before I do, I've got a huge favor to ask. I am in the middle of developing a brand new webinar course. And one of the things that I need to find more good examples of are people creating great, compelling webinars. So if you have been to a great webinar, if there's one person who's delivered a webinar who you think they nailed it, it absolutely resonated with you, will you let me know? Will you comment in the box below and let me know what webinar really worked for you or who's delivering webinars that are making a difference for you? They can be educational, they can be sales, they can be training, they can be on any topic because there's such a broad spectrum of topics around the whole webinar scenario. But please comment below, let me know. I'm going to follow up, look at what's common amongst all those people creating great webinars, and I will be featuring some of them in bonus materials around the upcoming course. So you can do me a huge solid if you'd be so kind as to let me know who is kicking butt webinar-wise. Now, as far as I'm concerned, what are the 7 keys to creating great webinars? The very first key is message. Making sure you know what your message is. And this actually ends up encompassing a whole bunch of things. If you understand what it is you're going to try and deliver, what core value you're going to try and deliver in a webinar, it means that A, you know who your audience is. And you also understand the importance of niche, of focusing on a small set of information. One of the challenges with webinars is we try and over-deliver. We try and give too much. If we look at a typical webinar as being maybe an hour in length, with all of the administrative stuff that we have to do top and tail with the webinar, allowing for questions, etc., you probably have maybe 40 minutes of real content that you can deliver. Now, 40 minutes sounds like a lot, but it really isn't all that much time, especially when you want to tell people something and then reinforce that information and frame it with some good context. So making sure that you know what the core few things, maybe 4 or 5 points that you want people to learn, or maybe 7 like I'm doing right now, but the core things that you want to teach your audience are. That means you know your audience, you understand your content, and you maintain that sort of focus. The next thing is preparation, making sure that everything is set up for you properly and for your audience. Now, preparation goes way before the delivery of the webinar. The first thing around preparation is knowing your webinar software and having a good registration system, a good way to share information with people, making it easy for them to register and sign up. At the end of the day, you have to make the whole process very easy for your audience, very non-invasive for your audience. So having a good technical setup and a good registration system, a good follow-up system, and of course, really good robust software that you use to deliver the webinar, absolutely paramount. Then you have to consider your format is the third key. Now, the format takes a whole bunch of different criteria into play. What type of webinar is it? Is it a sales webinar? Do you have to have room to have some sort of a call to action at the end? Is it educational, where you might want to actually be testing people on what they're learning? Is it informational, where it's mainly just the delivery of content, but you have to make sure you give them access to follow-up information a little bit later? And what is your actual metaphor for delivery going to be? Is it going to be talking head? Are you going to have a lot of video? Is it going to be mainly slideshow? Are you going to do a hybrid webinar where you have live action plus pre-recorded and pre-taped action? You have to consider all of that. Plus, you have to consider what I consider to be the most important aspect of for success for a webinar is what sort of interaction are you going to have. One of the beauties of webinars is the fact that we can create an interactive environment, a dialogue. And the fact that people are at home when they're watching it actually means they can have higher levels of interaction than if you were to deliver the same content, say, in a seminar format. Because with the chat forums that we can have sidebarring or the ability to actually bring people in and ask questions and interact with you during the webinar, that creates an entirely unique layer of interaction, which if you really want to dive deep into the webinar pool and find exactly what it will do for you, you have to figure out how to manage that level of interaction. So when we speak about format, not only do we have to think about how we're going to draw people in through poll questions, through chat, etc., but we also have to figure out how we're going to manage that from a presenter's point of view, because the person presenting the content has to concentrate on delivery of great content. They can't be spending a lot of time interacting with the audience and watching the chat role, for example, mixed in with the questions and comments and encouragement are technical problems and questions that are completely non sequitur. You can't have them breaking their attention while they're trying to read their way through all of that content. So for my webinars, I like to have somebody hosting the webinar who produces it, who manages it like a radio. A live call-in radio show producer might do, screening the calls, forwarding the important questions into the host, etc. So that all falls under having a proper format and understanding the overall picture of what your webinar is supposed to look like as you deliver it. The next key is focus, and that really, everything that I've set up to now really relates back to focus, doesn't it? Making sure you know your audience, making sure you know your content, removing distractions from the host or from the presenter, making sure that they can focus on the delivery of great content, making sure that you've got focus, always your eye on the prize of what the webinar is about, essential to delivering good webinar content. Hat in hand with focus comes respect for not only yourself, but your content and your audience. You have to respect all of the different participants in this webinar. You respect yourself by doing the best possible job. You respect your content by preparing and rehearsing and making sure that it's delivered in the best possible light. And you also respect your audience by doing that. And you also respect your audience by delivering exactly what you promise. One of the things that bothers me most about a lot of the different sales webinars that I go into is people say they're going to teach you something, but they spend the entire webinar time selling you something that that theoretically will teach you, I guess, downstream. But the bottom line, if you say you're going to teach people how to do things, teach them that. Deliver what you say you're going to. It shows respect for yourself, your content, and your audience. And this next one is a difficult one to really to insist upon, but you've got to bring your own personality to the webinar. Now, people are going to spend an hour listening to you. They don't want to just listen to a canned speech. They want your personality. So if you're funny, if you're whimsy, if you're droll, bring that into the webinar, especially if you're creating a family of webinar products. If you're going to be consistently delivering a series of webinars, be consistent in how you present yourself. And I think the best way to do that is to be yourself. You know, people often ask me if, or when they meet me, they often comment that I'm just like I am in my channel. And I think I am just like I am in my channel or in my webinars, except when I'm recording, I'm a slightly amped up version. I have a little more voltage going through me when I'm delivering this sort of content. But that's very easy for me to do because I'm an extrovert. You have to find that inner extrovert in you and make sure that you're celebrating your personality and letting it flow through. That allows people to engage with you. It makes the content that much more valuable. I think you have to run the risk of pushing a few people away, of having some people that say, I don't like their style, and having them leave in order to really reach the people with your personality. So that's a risk that we all have to take, but is well worth taking. There's plenty of people delivering great content. Be unique, be yourself, allow people to engage with you, and then your content will resonate that much more. And the final step to creating a great webinar, as far as I'm concerned, is the follow-up. Making sure that you follow up with what you've promised. Whether that's an email of the recording, whether it's all a list of materials. Of course, if you're in a sales cycle, you're going to be following up with sales letters, but making sure you're following up with the content that you promised to deliver as well. Those, to me, are the keys to a great webinar. Let's see if I can go through them all. Message, focusing on your message and understanding your niche. Next is knowing your audience. Then preparation, making sure that all of your tools, your technology, everything's ready and in advance, that your audience has an easy way to register for the webinar, and that your delivery system is robust and ready to go. Figuring out what format you want to deliver and making sure you have a team to help you deliver that format. Focusing on your contact, respecting your content, yourself and your audience, allowing your personality to shine through, and finally, following up. There, that's my keys to a successful webinar, but they might not be the only, I know they're not the only keys to successful webinars, so I'm hoping that you folks who have stuck with me this long will let me know which webinars resonate for you so I can interview those people, look at what they're doing, and I can learn more keys to successful webinars so that I can share that with you as well. That's it. Now, there's three ways to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. The first, of course, subscribe to this channel. Second, this is very important, especially today, subscribe to our newsletter, because then you'll get notice of upcoming webinars that I'll be delivering, many of which will be about webinars in the coming months. And finally, Dotto Tech is a crowdfunded channel through our supporters at Patreon. If you want to find out what's involved in being a Patreon supporter and what perks there are, and the perks are indeed wonderful, drop by our Patreon page and have a look. That's it for today. Till next time, I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.